Hello guys, welcome to my channel. My name is Brianna. In this video, I am going to talk about my feelings and thoughts after reading the book, The Catcher in the Rye. So, The Catcher in the Rye is written by J.D. Salinger and published in the year of 1951. Ever since it is published, it has received very good reviews and comments, and it is among one of the literary canons out there in the literary circle. However, there are actually mixed comments, and especially during the time when it was published, around the time when it was published in the 1950s, 1960s, some schools even banned the book from being read by children, mainly because of its sort of cynical perspective towards the world. But overall, it is really a good book, and no wonder it has been prized as among the list of literary canons. Yeah, so what does this book talk about? Well, it basically details 2 days in the life of Holden Caulfield, the protagonist, who dropped out of prep school for Journey for Truth. And it records many of the incidents and interesting encounters that Holden experiences in his Journey for Truth. And after reading the book, several interesting thoughts that came up to my mind are the following. So the first of all, it would be the impact of family on Holden's development. And I want to talk about this from two perspectives. First of all, it's from the perspective of Holden's siblings. Well, Holden has a younger sister in a family whose name is Phoebe. And because Phoebe is younger than Holden, Holden has this brotherly affection and instinct towards her. And he is always striving to protect the piece of innocence that Phoebe embodies. Because, well, there's an incident in the book where when Holden decides to go home after wandering on the streets for quite a long time, his purpose was actually to see Phoebe instead of to see his parents. This really points to the fact that Holden has this special connection and bond to his younger sister. And when he goes back home, he saw that Phoebe was sound asleep, and he was like, he just adored how Phoebe's serene and calm expression is showcasing her innocence and authenticity. He loves the piece of authenticity and simplicity that is on Phoebe, and because of Phoebe, he tries and strives to protect this piece of innocence on every young child's heart. Yeah, moreover, Phoebe as a character is actually quite mature for her age. When she's bullied by one of her classmates, she didn't like cry and complain like most other kids would at that age. Instead, she calmly states to Holden that she thinks what the boy did wasn't correct, and this like calm communication and the ability to convey her feelings is quite influential on Holden as well. So Holden is picking up this sense of responsibility and getting the importance of communication from his younger sister Phoebe, and that has a huge influence on his identity construction. What's more, in terms of Holden's parents, they aren't exactly very warm and close to him from the book, because Holden is constantly getting into trouble in his prep school, boarding school. So he has been kicked out of school for multiple times and has to be relocated to other schools in order to continue his education. Because of this, his parents are actually quite mad at him. And when he is again kicked out from the Pensy prep school, and he goes back home, Holden is afraid that their parents would be extremely mad. And this this kind of feeling points to the fact that their relationship isn't exactly very close, and their parents being away from Holden aren't exactly able to see the efforts that he has been putting into his own education and his own identity construction. Yeah, so like I think Holden is actually quite fortunate to live in a family where he has supportive siblings, even though his parents may not be as supportive. Overall, he has been like hugely influenced by his family environment, and that's something very important to consider in terms of childhood development. On to the next point, I want to talk about the impact of childhood trauma on teenagers' growth. For Holden, he has experienced the loss of his younger brother, Ali, at the age of 13, because his brother had leukemia, a kind of a cancer that was very deadly. So, however, like, the sad thing is that when his brother died, Holden was extremely sad and angry that he punched stuff in a garage, leading to his injury on his hands and arms. So he had to be taken to the hospital that night, resulting in his absence at his brother's funeral. This thing continues to haunt him as he grows up, because Holden is very regretful for what he did and what he and the fact that he wasn't able to attend his dear brother's funeral. From Holden's description, it can be seen that Holden also sees his younger brother Ali as the perfect child, as he is calm, as he is innocent, simple, and all the characteristics that is in opposition to the idea of phoniness that Holden holds towards all the rest of the society. So this kind of experience is continuously haunting him as he grows up, because he's very regretful and he goes back to the memory very often. And he cannot think of his brother without this sort of like mental struggle in his mind. Because of this, his parents actually suggested taking him to be psychoanalyzed, but it didn't happen eventually. However, the effect and impact of this childhood trauma continues to haunt him. And it can be seen that Holden doesn't exactly have some sort of like outlet for his emotions and regrets. So he's left on his own to figure out ways to deal with his own mental health issues. And this points to the fact that teenagers like Holden are not sort of like the innocent group of people as usually like stereotyped by the entire society. Instead, everybody has their own inner struggle, and sometimes without proper support, their mental health could be devastated because of that. Finally, I want to touch upon the idea of phoniness. For me, this like the phoniness that Holden is continuously fighting against is sort of the idea that people are inauthentic. They are like, they appear in a way, but they're actually in another way. So basically what they do and what they are contrasting, and like they're just so opposite and so different that Holden just cannot stand this phenomenon. For example, in his roommate at Pensy Prep, Stradlater, the handsome, popular, and charming guy at school, actually has a sloppy interior, because beneath his overall charming appearance, his own actions inside the dorm and his like own sanitation and stuff aren't exactly very good, and Holden is able to see all of this. So from him, Holden sort of learns how like even teenagers, even his peers, are being heavily influenced by the societal norm to like appear one way but actually act another way. So this like premature inauthenticity and premature pretense that people like Stradlater are already putting on themselves is actually like very annoying for Holden. So like because of his interaction with people like Stradlater, Holden is always trying to fight against the sense of inauthenticity and trying to protect the young children's innocence, because to Holden it seems that the group of people who has the most innocent souls and who are the most authentic is all children. So basically, Holden tries to be this catcher in the rye to catch children falling off so that their innocence can be protected. And this entire rejection and confrontation of the societal norm to hide their true identity is what Holden is fighting for. So I guess it's partially because of this kind of sense of rejection of the societal norm tradition that caused some of the negative reviews and like rejections of the book at the beginning when it was published. However, when we really look into this, it sort of reflects the cultural context at the time this was written, because there was at the time of 1960s, there was this counterculture movement that was prevailing in the United States, And the generation of baby boomer has grown to become teenagers, and they are consistently rejecting the way of life of their parents. So their new way of approaching life and living their different kinds of lifestyle is changing the entire outlook of society. And people are being cynical. They are rejecting the last generation's way of life. And that sort of has led to this entire idea of rejecting the phoniness out there in the world depicted by J.D. Salinger in his book, The Catcher in the Rye. Yeah, so that is all that I want to comment on the book, The Catcher in the Rye. And overall, I would highly recommend to you, but I do believe that most of us have read it. So yeah, that's just something I think about this book. And keep in mind that I am really just an amateur reader, and these are only what I think. So if you have anything else to comment on this book, or you disagree with me on some of the points that I've mentioned, feel free to leave them down below in a comment section. Else, please do like and subscribe. Leave a comment down below if you have anything to add to the discussion. And thank you very much. I will see you next time. Bye.